As we have discussed earlier, there are different types of functions. There are hundreds of them. There are some financial ones that you can use, and as business students you could probably utilize in the future. Notice it's a lot of them, and if you click on any of those, it will tell you what it does and how it is used. Now, and how it is used, some of those are pretty complex, so you could use this help function right here, or you could also search over here under the Microsoft Excel help. But let's assume that we want to calculate the mortgage payments. A couple of things that you can do, like you can calculate the payment itself on a loan, you can calculate the interest that you are paying for that loan, and then you can also calculate the principal payment for that specific loan. And this is just to give you an example of how it works and just to understand the concept. So for example, we have the interest rate at 6%, and then there are 12 payments for that every year for that payment. So let's say that our loan is going to be, let's say it's a car loan, and you get a car loan for $20,000. So that'll be PV, and then basically you have the interest rate at 6%, and then also when you get a loan, it's going to tell you how many years you're going to pay that loan. So for example, it's going to be 5 years. Now 5 years, I have it here, the number of payments. The number of payments is basically the number of payments per year. It's 12. 5 years times 12 is 60. So this 60 here comes from B4, this number right here, 12 months times the number of years, and that gives us the number of payments. So if we look on the PMT function in Excel, that basically needs the rate, which is per month, then it needs the number of payments and PER, which would be 60 months, and we are calculating that with the formula here, of course, and then it wants also the PV, the present value of your loan. So now we want to calculate down here what your monthly payment will be for this car, this nice. So the way it works is that you click on insert function, and then you find the function for PMT. So you kind of have to know what that is. Somehow you have to search it and so on. So you click OK here, and you click on rate. Notice the rate is the monthly rate. So 6% divided by 12 here, it would be this rate per month. So the rate here would be B5. Then NPER, the number of payments, is this one, B7, equals 60 in this case. And then the PV is the present value, which we have picked a loan of $20,000. So now all you have to do is you click on OK here, and notice if you're getting a loan for a car for $20,000 at 6% rate, you have to pay for 5 years or 60 months $386.66. Now, let's say you have good credit for $20,000 for 5%. Now notice what will happen to your payment. You hit enter. From 386, you have to pay only 377 a month. Now, what about if you had to, let's say, 8%? Notice you have to pay $405 every month. So that's the payment per month. Now, what about if we want to calculate the interest that you're paying every month for your, or the interest payment? So what do we do here? We use the same formula or the same setup. We go to this next cell, and then we go under insert function, and we look for IPMT. And there it is. Double click on it, and then we want to know the rate. Well, this is our rate, because it's calculated based on our interest rate. So actually that was not happy with me because I clicked OK too early. And then the PER, it wants to know the PER is a period for which you want to find the interest. So the period in this case, it would be, for example, for one period, for 1 month, that we want to find this payment, interest payment. We could change this to see it for 60 months if we wanted. Then we want the number of the NPER, So that would be the number of payments. In this case, it's 60. And then the present value, it's 20,000. So again, what we are doing here, we're just looking at these values and then just putting the references for each one of them except for the number of payments. Now we click on OK. And basically, what we are doing in the first payment, we are paying $133 in interest. Now, think about it this way. If you're buying a $300,000 house, for example, in Langhorne, that's what houses go for, and you're getting a loan for $300,000, and you're paying 8% interest rate, now, of course, this comes in to be very expensive because, you see, this is only for 5 years. Usually, the mortgages are for 30 years. So you hit enter there. So at 8%, if you have bad credit, a $300,000 house without any additional taxes or anything, it's going to be $2,201. Now, your interest on that first payment for $300,000, it's going to be $2,000. And you're paying basically the principal only $200, actually, $201. Now, if you have good credit, and this is where it comes in handy, if you have, let's say, you get an interest rate of 4%, notice that it will go, the payment will go from 2,200, I change it to 4%, it goes to $1,400. And that's why the interest rate and your credit score is important, and notice that on that first month's interest payment, it's going to be only $1,000 rather than $2,000. So if you wanted to get something, let's say for $200,000 house, this would be your payment, $954. And that would be your interest payment on the first month. Now, if you wanted, say, the payment on, let's say, for 30 years, it's going to be 320 and 360 payments, because they're 30 times 12, it's 360. Let's say on the fifth payment, how much you're going to be paying for interest. So let's say 5, and now it's 829. It's less than the first month. Now it's 829. First month it was 833, so you're kind of getting it less. Now let's calculate the principal payments. So the principal, and notice it is PPMT, it's the rate, the number, and then number of payments, and then the present value. So we go here under insert function, we choose PPMT, click OK, and then the rate, it's this one, which we can change it at any point. PER, we, let's say, the first payment. Then we want the NPER, that's that one, the basic number of payments. Present value is the loan, and then click OK. So basically, all you have to do here is notice that IPMT, the interest payment, it's these values as we defined earlier. And the, for the PPMT, all you have to do is use the same formula, but just change the function to PPMT. So notice PPMT B51, so for payment number 1, and then 7 is the number of payments per year, and then 8 is that. So basically what it's saying here is that the first payment for your mortgage of $200,000, it's going to be only of $240. If you had the more at 5%, if that was at 8%, then it would be this much, only $134. Now, so basically, that's some of the concepts in financial calculations and financial functions here. There's lots of them, and you could Google this stuff, you could check them out for yourselves, either from the help menu over here, or as you're inserting the functions, depending on what you're trying to do. Unfortunately, we'll not be able to learn all of these things in this class.